completely relaxed, AJ. You witness events. They cannot affect you.
Okay.
Okay, now, you said you left Jake's with Carly. You knew a place where you could be alone.
Jason's room. I have a key. We're going up the stairs into the hall. She's leaning against me. We stop and kiss. We get to Jason's door. Open. We go inside. We're kissing. I'm kissing her.
Initiate confrontation. Give yourself a little room before you deal with this.
So I tell her that I know what it is. That I don't do this all the time.
No, I don't do this all the time.
She's kissing me. I want her so much. I want to make love to her.
What do you see?
I can't.
Do you want to come out?
No, not yet.
That was unbelievable. I don't do this all the time.
She's kissing me. I want her so much. I want to make love to her.
What do you see? Do you remember?
Yes.
Can you tell me what you saw?
No.
AJ, anything you tell me, I can keep confidential.
I understand, and I'm grateful. But...
It's all right. All right. AJ, keep in mind something. Recovered memories can be pretty traumatic. None of the defense mechanisms like denial, rationalization, or even disassociation, which comes with the passage of time, are going to function for you here. It's as if whatever you just remembered happened tonight. You're not really in a good state of mind to make decisions or initiate confrontation. Give yourself a little room before you deal with this.
I will. I think what I need right now is to be alone.
I understand. Well... Oh, by the way, congratulations on the sobriety. That's a hard road, I know, but I have a feeling you'll make it this time.
Thank you, and congratulations on your...
On my sanity. Yeah, there's something very liberating about having crashed and burned. I don't know, maybe it's seeing your worst self and knowing that you survived. Then again, maybe it's just not having to wear a tie.
Yeah, I tell myself the same thing. Thank you, Kevin.
Glad I could help.
See ya.
Yeah. Look, AJ, Carly doesn't always mean well, but she usually means something.
Did I force myself on you?
You didn't do anything that was crude or obnoxious in any way. You're always going on about that night at Jake's and wondering what happened.
You didn't want to cut me off. You just wanted me out of town?
the greatest liar the world's ever known, or you're more screwed up than I've ever dreamed of being.
A lot of things happened between us.
I wouldn't have bothered you.
You never bothered me.
But you didn't want to cut me off. You just wanted me out of town?
I didn't have a choice, okay?
Yeah, you meant something, all right. You meant to ruin my life.